At the Alzheimer's Disease Research Summit 2015, the second in a series of summits mandated by the National Plan for Alzheimer's Disease, conference attendees were energized by new opportunities bringing them closer to the goal of treating and preventing Alzheimer's by 2025.
The atmosphere at this meeting is one of high energy. People are very enthusiastic. It started out with Francis Collins talking about where we've come.
I think we've entered a new era in Alzheimer's research. There are new models of collaboration and data sharing. There are fantastic advances scientifically.
Participants were urged to use the conference to share insights and move forcefully to advance the fight against Alzheimer's disease.
I hope you will all feel the exhilaration that Francis communicated, that I hope I have reinforced, and take it as your charge in these next days to make the very best of this opportunity to share your wisdom, your interaction, communication, and put that forward toward our charge for the next years in our fight against Alzheimer's disease.
Attended by stakeholders from a broad cross-section of the research community, the conference focused on several themes, starting with the complex nature of Alzheimer's disease itself.
There are multiple pathways to actually getting Alzheimer's dementia. You might have diabetes, you might have cardiovascular disease, you might have a genetic risk factor. Those different risk profiles mean that I might get Alzheimer's one way and you might get Alzheimer's dementia another way.
Participants heard about new approaches to drug development.
A theme that really emerged was around systems biology. And how can we use systems biology as perhaps a new way to get progress in Alzheimer's disease drug discovery.
And the importance of sharing data.
So data sharing is an opportunity to aggregate, to bring large amounts of data together and to ask, what is it in that data that is showing us a pattern? Patterns of risk, patterns of, are there therapies out there that would actually work to prevent or delay Alzheimer's disease?
They heard about finding ways to prevent Alzheimer's disease using pharmacological and non-pharmacological approaches.
We have evidence that things like how you live your life, the kind of experiential factors you have, the kind of psychological factors that make you up, and the kind of medical factors, we already have good evidence that a lot of these things can either protect your brain or put your brain at greater risk. All right, and if we could understand these at a mechanistic and a biological level, all right, we may be able to find therapies that can help people.
And also the challenges involved in finding effective dementia care strategies.
There are a lot of challenges because dementia is a very complex disease, and the needs of families change over time. So what they need in the early stages of the disease are very different at the end stage.
A new emphasis was given to promoting more public-private partnerships and greater citizen engagement.
We've heard about the cool technologies, we've heard about the importance of new methods, new tools to collect data, engaging citizens, but actually in the end, you've got to put it together in the partnerships.
So the reality is that we need to work together. And if we do not work together, then our goal of curing Alzheimer's by 2025 cannot be met. Because in drug discovery terms, 2025 is the day after tomorrow.
We've got to have the research community and the lay community work with one another in order to further the things that we both care about deeply.
Usually the researcher comes into the project and designs the entire study. But now we're finding out that communities have a voice and they want to know what's important for their communities.
Though there is much that needs to be done to meet the goal of treating and preventing Alzheimer's by 2025, participants left the summit quite hopeful.
I'm very hopeful for the outlook of finding therapies, especially preventive therapies.
I'm very hopeful. There are, thousands of scientists and clinicians who are working together. We've committed our life to this endeavor. This is our life purpose. This is our life passion. We're not giving up.
For more information about the research summit, visit www.nia.nih.gov.